Good morning, good afternoon, and good evening. Happy Bringing. Today we are running our Entrepreneur Hour number 5, and we have Sankalp with us. Sankalp, please introduce yourself and do share about what is that you are looking at this hour with me.
Sure, sir. It's feeling great. Here being with you. So my name is Sankalp Saxena. I'm 20 years old from Aligarh, Uttar Pradesh, a small town in UP. And I did my 12th last year. And since then I started doing freelancing as a content writer since the pandemic hit, because I didn't want it to set free, wanted to do something. And
yeah, go ahead, Sankalp. I'm really sorry.
Sure. So I started doing freelancing since last year as a content writer. And later on in the month of October, I joined a startup of my friend. He started a digital marketing agency. And I worked there for about 2 months. And in that period, I found it interesting. The whole startup ecosystem, and I always wanted to create something on my own. So I was started looking not consciously, but in the back of mind, I had a vision to create something. So I was just going around on internet, and I found out that there's a lot of scams and frauds happens with the tourists and travelers when they travel to a new place or to a new country or to a new city. Especially with the newbie travelers who are new to traveling, who are traveling for the first time, they always has this concern or sort of fear in their mind of not knowing the do's and don'ts when traveling to a completely new place. So it triggered my mind of why not create a platform where we can help creators, travelers, travel scam-free and fear-free without hesitating to visit places which are actually beautiful, but few people like scamsters, they try to hurt these travelers. So since then, like since January, I thought of this idea and started working on this idea. So this was about me. Hello.
Sankalp, am I audible?
Yes, sir, you're audible.
Okay. What I'm saying is, so you want to know, you want to build up a startup which is on a basis on a travel. Okay.
Yes.
Now, what is the uniqueness which you are trying to bring it over there?
Sure, sir. So, unlike other travel platforms, we won't be providing any travel packages or tour packages. Instead, we are targeting the segment where people, some scamster and fraudster try to fraud or scam travelers while they are traveling or visiting the new place. And in a lot of countries, it's considered a proper crime against foreigners. So this is what I'm trying to tackle.
I still didn't get your idea. What exactly you're looking at?
So basically, if you are traveling to a new place, you might end up coming across some scamster who would scam you into buying overpriced products or overpriced tickets for some goods and services. And after that, you'll come to know that their original price is not that much. And there are all like there are many types of scams happens with travelers. So I'm trying to build a platform where we will educate and provide all the systems to the travelers so that they can travel fear-free and successfully complete their trip without ever getting scammed.
And how will you do that?
I think so. The basic idea is to create an application, a smartphone application and web application that will be based on AI. So that if you just turn on your location and the mobile application, so it will show you all the do's and don'ts and all the necessary things you must know about the area you are standing. And all the things that can happen in that nearby area where you are at that point.
So how different it would be from a Google app, you know, like if you see in Google also, you can actually just, say it Google and it will show you certain places nearby, which are generally validated. So how will it be different from that perspective?
So, sir, we won't be showing like places. Instead, we won't like suppose I'm standing in Sao Paulo, which is in Brazil. It's a famous place where for tourists and foreigners, and it's also famous for a lot of thieves and robbers who rob in a bright sunlight day foreigners while they're just standing or walking and doing anything. So these things happen often with foreigners. So the application, the way the application will work is that once they turn on the location and the application, our application will show all the scams and all these bad things in that nearby area that happens. And this will all be validated by users only. So I'm also building a community to validate and these scams. So that I can build, I can provide my customers a trust so that they can trust these information.
So have you zeroed it down to a location where you want to start with first?
Yes, sir. So I will be starting from Delhi because that's the most I have most information about that city as of now. From mostly from internet, so I will be starting putting up information and details about scams and frauds in Delhi first.
Yeah, but how will it help somebody? See, let's say I am going to Delhi to travel.
Okay.
Now, as a user, why will I visit to your website and what will I get? Something instantaneously. See, if I have to read through all of those things, I probably can Google it also, right? I will get so much information. Now, how is going to be helping me as far as your app is concerned?
Sure, sir. So, like, assuming if you are visiting first time in Delhi, but that's what I'm assuming. So, you probably won't have much idea or information of which place to visit. To explore or not, and even if you try to search it on Google, you'll have to go through a lot of websites, blogs and articles and read all those materials. That would probably take more of your time and without providing you like exact information that you're looking for. So we'll be churning down that information into a very concise and short form which will be in like few 50-60 words. Something like in short, and it will save you a lot of time and it also give you the exact insight that you're looking for of any specific place.
Okay, so it will be basically about the information about that area which you will be congregating into this application. Is that what I'm understanding, right?
Yes, sir. And the main information will be around the scams and frauds, like what scams can happen in this area. and how can you protect yourself from being scammed, or how to deal with those. So that will be the information.
How big is the problem?
So sir, when I searched it on internet, I found out a few research websites and few guidelines of various countries, such as found of UK and few other European countries who have published guidelines about some specific countries for their native citizens if they are traveling to that particular country. And those reports consist of all the information and the data that they have collected over the years of the crime committed towards foreigners and especially towards travelers. It's pretty massive, and like almost mostly you'll get scammed in money, but the scammers are like really smart, and they'll find they have like various ways to scam you, and without even letting you get to know it. It mostly happens in the Southeast Asia, South America, and in some countries in Europe. But it's also a worldwide issue which I'm trying to tackle, starting from Delhi, like small city.
Okay. So have you tested it out with some few people, giving this information to them? Are they finding it useful? Have you started doing that, or it is just a thought right now?
Yes, sir. So I, like as a beginner, I didn't have any budget to spend any ads. So I went on Facebook and joined few travelers groups, like channels over there. I requested their admins, and I showed those admins my idea. And so my basic idea was to run a few Google form over those channels, over those groups. So I requested their admins to allow me be a part of their group and ask their fellow travelers about some insights. So I did got some insight about 7 to 8 places, 7 to 8 kind of scams that happened. So I think that got me some trust that it like the problem exists, but I need to do a lot more real-time research with the travelers to actually validate. So as of now, I'm planning to start my inbound marketing, which is I will be creating my internet my presence over internet by creating Instagram pages, Facebook pages, and presence over all other channels such as Tumblr, Reddit, Discord, where most youth and most people spend their time on. So I will be creating my presence over there, and this is my the current idea, current method to validate it. So this is what I will be doing.
Okay. See, idea sounds good.
Okay.
But you really need to see how you are going to bring it into POC.
Because
what is important is that who are going to be the customers who are going to pay you, from whom you are going to charge.
All right.
Have you thought on that?
Sir, as of now, I have narrowed down my target segment, which is the first time travelers or the newbie travelers who are traveling for the very first time. So like these are the people who I will be trying to connect or reach out to.
See, I think post COVID, one of the biggest requirements for travelers is, if I travel to this city, what are the COVID rules for airport, for bus stations, for railway stations, for the local public? I think that itself is going to be a huge requirement into that. Like, I keep traveling to various parts of the globe.
Okay.
Every time I travel, this is the first thing which I check.
Okay.
Apart from the scamsters and all that is probably a later part of it. Now, as soon as I want to know about when I want to visit, the first thing which I want to know is there any restrictions around?
All right.
Whatever said and done, the COVID is going to remain for at least, COVID issue is going to remain at least for the next 3 to 5 weeks, minimum.
Okay.
Okay. So my thought is, why don't you first of all start with that information and then tell them that, okay, start with the basic things like, you know, these are the places you can visit if you're a traveler, if you're a tourist. Maybe you can line up certain hospitals in case of medical emergencies. You know, maybe they can get infected or something like that, or some laboratories in that area that you can easily integrate with some existing Google APIs.
Okay, sir.
Maybe you can add some information. So you might already have got some information from various websites. You can just integrate that. Rather than creating your own content, leverage other things, bring it into a process. Because what you're telling me is that as soon as you enter into, or you want to travel to a particular place, you want to know what are the places available, what are the airport guidelines, what are the COVID guidelines. You know, what are the scams? You know, there could be a possible scams over there as well. So let's say somebody is visiting to South Africa. What could be the potential threat? What are the things you need to take care of? There could be a language barrier. There could be a way of communication or the culture barrier. Like I remember when I was traveling to Dubai, I had actually done a research a lot on the social media. And there are so many websites. Which I kind of referred through. And what I realized is that they have certain way of talking, certain way of, invitations and, you know, talking to people. Like if you go to their homes and if they're offering you a tea or a coffee, you cannot say no.
Okay.
You cannot say no. Because that means that they have considered you as a family. Otherwise, they will not even offer you. And let's say you're reaching to a place, somebody's home, but they're having dinner. You will have to sit on the table, dining table, or have something, whatever you can. And don't talk about business. Typically, in Indian scenario, what we do is, hum kahin bhi jaate hain, baithte hain, apna business jo baat karna hai, kaam karna shuru kar de. They don't like it. They want to have personal relationship first. So these are very cultural issues.
Okay.
Now, are you going to cover that also?
Yes, sir. So, like the as you mentioned, like the language part and like the basic itinerary, which is how to adapt to the culture and how to communicate with people whom language is different than yours. So, I will be covering the language and the culture part.
See, in my opinion, our idea still needs to be more clear. Okay.
Okay, sir.
What you need to do. There can be several things which you can do within your business, your idea. It's the starting of the idea, I understand that. But now start converting it into a business model. When I say business model, who are your customers? Who are going to pay you? See, the people who are visiting Delhi or any place for that matter, they have enough. They're happy with the information which is available on Google.
Okay.
They are not going to pay you. Just because you're aligning that better, they are not going to pay you.
Got it, sir.
Right. Even Make My Trip took so many years to literally charge for those packages. I mean, a convenience fee. Otherwise, people are not even paying the convenience fee.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Even after getting so many benefits around that, of discounts and other things.
Okay.
So you need to see who is going to be your customer. Like if you have mentioned InShots, do you know who is the customer of InShots who actually pays to them?
No, sir, I don't know.
You don't pay for it, right? You read the news freely.
Yeah. I thought news free.
Yeah, they're invested. They have got $40-50 million by now already. Right?
Yes.
Who is paying to them? Who are their customers?
I think they run ads on their platform.
It's not the youth. It's the businesses who are running ads. Anybody.
Okay.
So their income comes from the advertising.
Sorry.
So you need to figure out from where you will make money.
Okay, sir.
And you need to decide whom you have to give it the benefit around that. Now, are you looking at making this? So what is your real purpose of having this app? You need to decide. And who is going to benefit from that? Now, if it is only about the aggregation of a content for a particular city in terms of various things, I think it is just about gathering more information in a structured format.
Okay.
Right? But yes. Will the travelers pay for it? May not. Because there are a lot of online things available, or maybe you know, local guides available. That guides may or may not be sufficient enough, that I understand. And you're trying to make it, basically bring them digitalized money. That could be one area.
Yes.
But will they pay for it? So now what you should do is maybe run a Google form or a survey.
Okay.
And figure out that how much people are ready to pay. So if you give them this kind of thing, are they ready to pay for it? And see how many people say yes, we are ready to pay. And if they say yes, how much they are ready to pay?
Okay. Understood.
Even with 50-100 people who you do a survey, at least you'll get a fair idea.
Yeah.
Okay. Then if let's say you figure out that they are not able to pay or they're not ready to pay, you can reach out to the vendors. That okay, I'm going to put your information there, I'm going to put your advertisement there. So that you will be available. You are available to them when they need. Okay, or I will show it to them. So let's say they search, you know, on my application, they're trying to search for, groceries nearby.
Okay.
Or maybe somebody has forgotten the toothpaste or whatever is that. You know, I'm just giving a very vague example. So then I will show your ad or I will promote you. Now, initially, you may give them free listing or something like that. As soon as you start giving or work on a revenue sharing model, but once you start getting some more traction, you can even start a subscription model like your OLX and other people.
All right.
You need to decide who are going to be your customers, whom you are going to charge.
Okay, my customers.
Then only your business model is complete.
All right.
So go through something called business model canvas. Are you aware about this?
Is it something where we write about our USP metrics, something like that?
Yeah. So you write your USP, you write your revenue streams, you write your cost streams, you write your problem statement solution. You can check online. If you Google it out, you'll get so many information around that. Type business model canvas or lean canvas and you will get Uber ka case study, Ola ka, bahut sare companies ka aapko mil jayega. Refer that and create your business model canvas first. That's a one piece of document which you should always have in front of you and keep perfecting it up.
Okay.
It will evolve. It will not be the same every time. But at least you will have a very broad level idea what exactly you are trying to do, from where you are going to make money. And then test it out one by one. So that is your idea. Convert it into a business model. Then you start reaching out to your target segment, your customers, and see whether they are ready to pay.
All right. Understood, sir. Yeah. So this is the process I have to follow.
This is the first step for you. Okay, there are 105 factors. Levels which you need to follow through eventually before you design your unicorn.
All right.
Okay.
Understood, sir. Thank you for the insight. Definitely.
I'm sending you my another private WhatsApp group link which I share with people who join my entrepreneur app. Join that, and if you have any questions, it's an open group. It's not a closed group like Telegram one. You can join that and ask your questions, anything, whatever is there on that group itself. if I feel that there is a need of a call, I will set up a call.
Definitely, definitely do it. All right.
Chalo. Okay. Okay. All the best. Take care.
Got it, sir. So just one thing. Can I also get the recording of this?
I will share that. I will upload this on YouTube channel of ours.
Okay, okay, okay. All right. Got it.
Okay.
Bye, sir.
You have got the WhatsApp group list?
Yes, sir. I have joined it.
Okay.
Bye.